Hey friends, well, after a week and a bit of having the most fun ever in Los Angeles, when is Los Angeles not fun, let's be honest, it's finally come time to sling my hook in search of, I don't know about greener pastures, maybe browner pastures. I'm going to be driving from Los Angeles to Albuquerque. And I figured it'd be fun to make a little video, see what we find on the way. I'm gonna miss this city. It's kind of become like my second home over the past couple of years. I'm gonna miss Venice, I'm gonna miss Santa Monica, I'm gonna miss Hollywood, I'm gonna miss Fairfax, I'm gonna miss La Cienega. I'm certainly gonna miss you, Sepulveda. You know why. Yeah, sad to leave, as always. The city's been incredibly good to me, apart from the first couple of times I visited when I pretty much just went to the really awful touristy bits. But now I feel like I've cracked the code and I know the good spots. So I don't think it'll be too long, hopefully, before I'm back here again. But until then, please join me for an exciting cross-country road trip alone. Across the United States of America. Well, three states. Certainly not gonna miss you, LA traffic. See you later, LA. Gonna miss you. Pass some really odd things when you're driving in this country. Like this bridge that I've just passed under is apparently the Sonny Bono Memorial Interchange. Thanks, Sonny. And I think this over here is the Cher Memorial Walmart. That's where she used to like to go to get her wigs and stuff. Here we are, stopped at a little truck stop to get some gas, sorry about the wind. And wait a second. What is that? There is just no way that I'm not going to check that out. Wow. Look at that! It's like made from metal. And it's being pulled by horses. They do not look happy to be trapped in there with that guy. Wow, that was crazy. Amazing the sort of things you find at these truck stops. I think it's pretty safe to say that that is the biggest dinosaur I'm gonna see today. Goodness. I can't quite believe what I'm seeing. As if I needed a reason to turn off the interstates and check out cool stuff. Those are some mighty big feet you've got there. Less said about the arms, the better. I bet these guys do a roaring trade. Well, Mr. Rex, if it's good enough for Huell Hauser, it's good enough for me. Clever girl. It's kind of the creepiest dinosaur I've ever been under, I think. Tell 'em Large Marsh sent you. Not really a reference we get in the UK. I don't think we ever got much of Pee-wee's Playhouse. I think that's what the reference is from. Maybe a movie? Yeah, I don't know. Please write in the comments if you can think of anything in the UK that has ever caused you to turn off a motorway just to see it. I honestly don't think we try hard enough, if I'm honest. That's our bad.
Ah! A snake! Stop it!
And check this out. You can actually climb inside this long neck. I've been in many a gift shop, but I don't think I've been in a gift shop inside a dinosaur. I love America so much. I would really love nothing more than to stick around and see more of these dinosaurs. Unfortunately, I need to get back on the road because I can't really afford the time. But this has been cool. Goodbye, dino friends! Hope you don't go extinct. Would you look at all those windmills? Even up there on the top of the hill. That's a buttload of mills. The sun has set. Ugh. So I'm not really sure if you're just meant to stop on the side of the road out here, but I just had to get a quick shot of this amazing sunset. It's crazy how the gradient of color changes from this very kind of Carsland-esque silhouette of the mountains here. And you go around to the east and it goes kind of beautifully red towards that end of the spectrum. The sun is setting, my hair's getting blown all over the place. I think it's probably time to call it a day for today. Of course, I still have further to go on my trip. So for tonight, good night, California. Hello, Arizona. With your incredibly long trains. Look at the size of it! You join me on a very cold morning here in Flagstaff, Arizona. I had one of these bad boys going right past the front door of my motel room last night, and contrary to, I guess, most people, I didn't care one bit. It was awesome seeing it go past, feeling the rumble. And it didn't impede me getting to sleep. In fact, it probably helped because it was blinking cold last night. Also, it's like super dry here. My nose is kind of tapping out. And also it affects the static discharge. I keep like touching the car door and getting massive shocks. And even last night, I was rubbing my fingers on my pillow in my room and it was making like little light sparks things dance across my pillow. It was very entertaining. I was pretending I was Harry Potter or one of those such guys. It's so cold. The camera is not coping with my involuntary hand spasms, even with the dedicated internal stabilization of the lens. So I think it's time we get back inside or find a nice warm rock to lie on like a rattlesnake. Oh, the Arizona weather is driving me a little bit crazy. Okay, let's go back to the car. That's better. I'm trying to get off the interstate a bit more today, see a bit more of Route 66 and also a few more of the cool kind of roadside attractions that I've gotten so used to visiting whilst here in the States. So let's see what Arizona has to offer. Toured off the interstate once again to check out a very interesting geological site right in the middle of northern Arizona.
When I first came to the States way back in 2004, this is one of the places that me and my buddies drove to just off the interstate.
We didn't actually end up going in because we were all starving students at the time, and when we got up to the door, it was like an $18 entrance fee. I know, 18 whole dollars. Couldn't even dream of having that much money back in 2004. So today is do-over day, and we're going to be checking out this incredible site. A true natural wonder. It's just up here. Okay, so up these stairs leads to a viewing gallery. Okay, so first clue, there's an Apollo test capsule here, which should give you some idea that this is a space-related stop-off. And honestly, knowing me, does it really surprise you? Okay, so I've switched to the wide angle because I feel like what I'm about to show you will require a sense of scale. And it's just around this corner. Take a look at this. How incredible is that? This is the Barringer Meteor Crater in northern Arizona, and it is one of the largest meteor craters in North America. That is quite some hole. As Marv would say,
wow, what a hole.
The scale of this place is even more impressive when you start to get down into it. It's just enormous. I mean, not quite Grand Canyon enormous, but almost. And there's a couple of cool, like, observation platforms, a little museum up the top that shows a film in the theater. Very cool place to stop. There are a couple of really good spots from where to see the various facets of the crater itself. Some nice touches of little plaques that tell you what are down here and various people who played important roles in the crater over the years. It's a pretty well thought out attraction. And of course, this guy who gave his name when he bought the place, Daniel Moreau Barringer. Luckily, he didn't live long enough to see his ideas about there being iron meteorites buried in the bottom that he could dig out come to fruition, but he did live long enough to see his theory about the
massive hole you see in front of you being caused by a meteorite to become pretty much generally accepted in the scientific world. What a great little stop. I'd love to stay longer, but unfortunately I have more stops to make on my trip. So let's go.
So, where to next? Well, it's somewhere that will be well known to fans of the Eagles. I'll leave it at that. This is gonna be such an on-the-nose reference that you're gonna be skipping through this video, trust me. Here I am in yet another Route 66 staple, Winslow. In fact, I'm standing on a corner in Winslow, Arizona. It's such a fine sight to see. Look, is that a girl?
My lord, in a flatbed Ford.
Take it easy, lady. So aside from the countless Eagles tie-ins, and the reliance on the town being an old staple of Route 66, this is actually a really nice old-timey American town. You know, I often wonder why it is that old-timey, quaint towns like this in America fascinate me, whereas, you know, much, much older, much, much quainter little towns in places like the UK aren't quite as interesting to me, and I still don't really know. I think the America that I grew up with, you know, the America of the movies and the America of the Wild West, is just so much more romantic to me than, you know, knights and castles and all the trappings of British kind of you know, history and mythology, kings and queens. And America is like Britain 2.0. all the rejects came over, didn't really like the way things were running in their own country, so decided to try something new. And America has pretty much been about trying new things ever since. And I think that's why I love it so much. They're still so young, but they've come a long way and they've done some really great things. another America thing that fascinates me for whatever reason is they are a lot less of a nanny state than the UK. So my parents noticed this as well. I'm right by a train track right now. The fence that would stop you from running onto that train track stops there. And the only thing that really stops you from going in there, if that's what you want to do,
is this sign that says no trespassing.
Now, if it was in the UK, there'd be fences everywhere, there'd be cameras, there'd be alarms, and if you dared step over this path, there'd be some guy there yelling at you, not afraid that you're going to hurt yourself, but afraid that he's going to end up in a court of law on the end of a massive lawsuit. So when we say that Americans are incredibly litigious, it's not exactly quite the case when it comes to stuff like this. They're just very common sense. We went to places like the Grand Canyon where, you know, you could literally walk right up to the edge. You were just free. And I know that that word gets bandied around a lot, especially in conjunction with America, where they love the idea of freedom. But it's true. Even in the little things like this, where you just think, you know, we couldn't do that in our country, but why? Why couldn't we do it? It's because we treat people like idiots. I don't know. But you definitely get a sense of true freedom out here. I just think even the little things like the lack of a fence here is something that I'd like to be a part of one day. So I was just driving out of Winslow and I thought that this was definitely worth stopping at. So I noticed as I drove past there's a flag out here flying at half mast and I was like, okay. But then as I got closer, it appears that it is a memorial. It is in fact a memorial to the victims of the September 11th, 2001 terrorist attacks in New York. And interestingly, they actually have two steel beams from the World Trade Center and the flag that was actually flown at the Pentagon. I find this part quite important, especially given the current turmoil of politics in the US, that they should remember not to fear terrorism. And not to turn this into something it's not, but I think that also extends to not allowing your fear of terrorism to turn into xenophobia of people who aren't from this country. Because there's a bit of that about at the minute. Yeah, interesting. So one more quick turn off the road to visit the small Route 66 town of Holbrook. There's not an awful lot in Holbrook, as far as I've been led to believe, but there is, just up here on the right, a piece of Americana roadside history. Parodied in everything from Cars Land to everything else, it's the Wigwam Motel. You too can spend the night in a little wigwam. How fun is that? What a great way to make people want to stay in your hotel. I still think we in the UK need to work a little bit harder if the best we can offer is Lenny Henry's Purple Palace, which will sound totally like I'm on acid to anyone not from the UK, but you guys know what I mean. So I'm not even going to stop here, I don't think, but this is Holbrook. Just one more place on a fantastic list of Route 66 attractions. Well, as much fun as this has been, I think I'm going to call it a day there. I'm gonna make a race to some friends in Albuquerque. Ooh, another dinosaur. And I hope you've enjoyed this little extra tour across the United States. It's been good for me. I've enjoyed it. So from me on the road, see you next time. Mexico.